This tutorial will show how to create a content distribution folder between teacher and students within Google Drive. We're going to use this folder so that the teacher can pass out digital items to their students all within the Google Drive environment while also maintaining the integrity of those documents. In other words, we're going to not allow the students to edit those master documents, but instead have them create copies of them. So first things first, let's create this content distribution folder. So in Google Drive, I'm going to come over here to the left-hand side and click the red Create button. And I'm going to create a folder. Now I'm going to give this folder a name that will be easily identifiable by my students. We'll call it Mr. Lawson's Files for today. I'm going to click the Create button. And now I have this folder in my Google Drive. Now I need to set the sharing permissions for this folder and give my students access. So I'm going to check off the box next to the folder so I can select it. And then you click on the Share button at the top. And I need now to invite my students to have access to this shared folder. You can either type in your student's name, account information one by one, or if you've already made a Google Contacts group, you can type that in as well. For example, here is a Google Contacts group of five people. The key here is to come over here and change the permissions of the invite from edit to can view. And we'll show what that why you want to do that in a moment. I'm also going to uncheck the notify people by email since students do not have access to the email app. Once this is done, students will go to the Shared with Me section of their Google Drive and locate the folder that you shared with them. They would then select that folder and choose to add it to My Drive for easy access. So that it now shows up over here in the My Drive section. Inside, they'll be able to find any files that you have decided to pass out or share with them. So here's a historical Facebook project document that has been shared with me, the student. If I open it, you'll notice that it is view only, because we set the permissions of the folder to be view only. So I can look at it, but I can't change it. In order to make changes to it, I, the student, need to make a copy of it. To do that, I'm going to come up to the File menu in Google Drive and choose Make a Copy. I can name it whatever I want. I can even remove the copy of part. And click OK. This opens up a new tab with a copy that I now can edit because I can have access to all the editing tools. I can then quickly come up here to this folder icon and move this document and put it in a folder I have for Mr. Lawson's class. If there's a shared folder that I need to put this in to turn it in to Mr. Lawson, I can move it right there as well. If the students are on an iPad, you can do the same thing, although the process is slightly different. To access the folder once you share it with them, they would click on the Shared with Me tool from the Google Drive app on the iPad. Find the folder and click the lowercase I tool so that they can get to the details screen as you can see here. They would then use the Move To item here to add it to their My Drive. Once in My Drive, to access files, they can either access Google Drive from their browser app and use the View Google Drive in desktop version, as you see down below here, so that they can access the document in view only mode and use that make a copy step that I showed earlier. Or if you want to stay within the Google Drive app, students can open up the file in view only and then use the select all and then copy tool and paste the content of the document into a brand new document that they create and they therefore own. So to review, the teacher creates a folder in their My Drive and then shares it with their students with the permission of view only. Once that's done, any documents you want to share with the student are added to that folder. The student takes that folder and adds it to their My Drive section for easy access. And if they're accessing it on a computer, they would open the view only files and choose file, make a copy. If they're on the iPad, they would then use either the desktop version within the iPad browser app or do a select all copy paste to transfer the content of that document into a new document in Google Drive. This concludes this tutorial.